In July 2014, this person tweeted, "Why didn't the two melons get married? Because they can't." Is this Abby? Dang, she's always with the jokes.
Because they can't elope. Michaela?
Someone told me this joke. I want to say it's Caitlin.
Yeah, I don't get it.
Is it Sierra? It is? Wow, I'm really like, what, Sierra? That's funny.
And first of all, I can't even catch a ball. Is that Sienna?
It sounds like something I would say. Who can't catch a ball? None of us can catch a ball.
Sienna. Dang it. Why do I think they're all Sienna?
First of all, I can't even catch a ball. Me. Actually, I'm not terrible. But I'm pretty bad also. Sierra? Kinsey? Okay. Sounds like one of her tweets.
In November 2017, this person tweeted, "Debating on moving to South Lincoln so I can be closer to Chick-fil-A."
Be closer to Chick-fil-A. Rachel?
Michaela. Taylor.
November 2017, this person tweeted, "Debating on moving to South Lincoln so I can be closer to Chick-fil-A." Taylor.
In August 2015, this person tweeted, "If you wear pants when you're home alone, you're doing it wrong." Me. That's something I would tweet.
When you're doing it wrong. Should have been me.
Me?
Why?
Because I walk around with no pants all the time.
Sierra.
I tweeted that?
I guess.
Thank you. Kinsey Roby, sophomore, Windsor Heights, Iowa.
Sarah Hardrow, freshman, Hendersonville, North Carolina.
Addy DeJesus, freshman, Greenwich, Connecticut.
Kaylee Quinn, freshman, Rockaway, New Jersey.
Michaela Curtis, sophomore, Savannah, Georgia.
Sierra Hassel, junior, Johnston, Iowa.
Megan Thompson, freshman, Gilbert, Arizona.
Taylor Houchin, junior, Republic, Missouri.
Abby Johnston, freshman, Parkland, Florida.
Annika Djakovic, sophomore, Kansas City, Missouri.
Megan Versalis Carr, sophomore, Los Gatos, California.
Rachel Thompson, sophomore, Lincoln, Nebraska.
Kelly Chung, senior, Torrance, California.
Sienna Krause, senior, Fargo, North Dakota.
Caitlin Oral, senior, Blue Springs, Missouri.
Megan Schweihofer, senior, China, Michigan.
I'm trying to think.
Tayo Cruz.
Yeah.
Is it Dynamite by what's his face?
Jason Derulo.
Oh. 2009. Oh.
Woo. Oh yeah.
Maroon 5.
Leaving California.
This month, Maroon 5, Red Album, Songs for Jane. Do I get bonus points for that?
This is like 2007, 2008.
2005.
What?
2003. Oh. 2005. I think that's like 5.
2002? CeeLo Green. CeeLo Green.
Oh, is it not? This is on Dance 4 for the week.
Hey, Usher.
Did you say Usher?
Yeah.
That's not way Usher, off, is it?
Hey, by Outkast. 2004.
Outkast with a K.
How do you even know that?
It's 2002.
Three. I knew I was close.
I don't know. Who sings it?
Kelly, she is the best teammate you could ask for.
She's literally sunshine in human form.
I think if you go back and watch the video from her first competition routine on bars, you could just see how much love this team has for her and how important she is to all of us. Like, I don't cry, and I had tears in my eyes after she finished her routine just because she works so hard in the gym that she deserves everything.
She's faced so much adversity, and it's really inspiring to me in the gym when she's working hard no matter what every single second of the day.
She can always put a smile on anyone's face every single day in and out of the gym.
I've never seen Kelly be anything but happy. And I think that that takes a pretty strong young woman with the challenges that she's been faced with. She worked her butt off day in and day out, ultimately because I think she enjoyed and loved this sport. She loved the team. She basically wears her heart on her sleeve, and I think that that's what makes Kelly unique.
She always strives to be the best that she can be, and if she's having a bad day, she will just push even harder to be better than she was. She's always super positive in the gym, and even if everyone's having a bad day, she's always really good at turning that around, and she always has the best mentality.
You've always been somebody that I've looked up to with your personality and just being happy all the time and not ever letting anything bother you, and you're just somebody that I absolutely adore and will always and always talk to you for forever and ever.
I guess the legacy I want to leave is to never let up and to keep striving for the best and always pushing yourself.
And I love you so much. You're the best. Like, you're the best cheerleader out there. You would give any cheerleader run for their money.
Hello and good evening. My
Don't
name is
let
Brooke
the hard
Rage,
days
and I'm here
define
with former
you
Husker gymnast
there are
Danielle
better
Breen.
Days to come.
Tonight, the 29th annual Masters Classic will take place, and the number 18 Nebraska women's gymnastics team is set to take the stage for the final time this season at home at the Bob Devaney Sports Center. The annual Masters Classic will feature number 9 Kentucky and Illinois State. Due to flight cancellation, Boise State will not be competing tonight. This meet will also serve as senior night for the Nebraska Huskers, with the four seniors, Kelly Chung, Sienna Krause, Caitlin Orrell, and Megan Schweighofer.
For tonight's lineups, the Huskers will start on the vault, Illinois State Redbirds will start on the bars, and the Kentucky Wildcats will be starting on the beam, where they are ranked in the top 10 nationally, coming in at number 8. So it should be a good competition tonight. Starting on vault, their lineup will be Annika Djakovic, Megan Versellis-Carr, Addy DeJesus, Taylor Houchin, Sienna Krause, and Kaylee Quinn.
Starting on vault, we have Annika Djakovic, the sophomore.
She'll be performing a Yurchenko 1.5, a 10-0 start value vault. Solid start for the Huskers, just the step on the landing. Good distance away from the table.
We're over to the bars with the Illinois State Redbirds. Starting off strong here. And a nice dismount with a stick.
Yeah.
Up next on vault is Megan Versellis Carr, another sophomore. Here she goes again with a 1.5.
Good vault, just that hop on the landing.
You can see that nice block off the table. A little bit of a hop back, but that should be a good score for her.
Very solid vault.
Up on vault is Addie De Jesus.
Another Yurchenko 1.5. You can tell she went for that stick, just a little shuffle backward. Three strong 1.5 so far to start the Husker vault lineup.
Annika Diakovic's score was a 9.8.
On beam, Warren started off with a
9.85. We're back to vault with Taylor Houchin.
Beautiful Yurchenko 1.5. Great form in the air, just that little hop on the landing. That should be a great score for the Huskers. Megan Versellis Carr came in with a 9.825.
Up on vault is senior Sienna Krause from Fargo, North Dakota. She will also be attempting a Yurchenko 1.5.
Great vault! Great vault for the senior. Great form, solid landing. Huskers off to a very strong start on vault.
Addie De Jesus had a 9.825 and Houchin had a 9.9. We'll go over to that replay. You can see that nice form in the air and just a slight hop on that landing. Should be a great score for Sienna.
Over on bars for Illinois State, Mia Quick started out with a 9.65 for the Redbirds.
And now back to the vault, we have freshman Kaylee Quinn.
Good height and distance in the air, just came up a little bit short there.
We're back over to bars. A bail to handstand.
Going back up to the high bar for her dismount. Good last handstand there. Nice routine, step on that dismount, but we missed the first part. Last half looked good.
The Huskers will. The Huskers will be exhibitioning Michaela Curtis now, the sophomore.
Just as a reminder, exhibition scores do not count towards the team's total. team puts up 6 gymnasts on each event for score, and the top 5 scores will count. As here goes Michaela. Solid Yurchenko full for the sophomore. Over on the beam, Kentucky's Josie Angeny put up a 9.2 in the number 2 spot. Krause put up a 9.85 on the vault as we go back over to the bars for Illinois State. Went for the Chaposh, just a little bit short. Kaylee Quinn had a 9.35.
Just getting back up and finishing that routine, trying to finish strong here.
Finish. Solid dismount. Back over onto the beam for Kentucky, we have Katie Stewart. Cool mount there. Required full turn. She's following Molly Korth's 9.825, excuse me, score. Just started with a solid leap.
Last week on beam, she had a career high with a 9.9. So let's see if she can do that again this week.
Very solid flight series there. Showing off some flexibility. And gets the stick on that dismount. That was a very solid routine for the Wildcats.
Back over to the bars with Sophia Irabaran.
Pretty nice line.
Seemed to peel off on that release. Hopefully she can get back up and finish her routine strong here.
The Huskers ended with a 49.2 on the vault. They will be heading to the bars next after Illinois State and Kentucky finish up on bars and beam, respectively.
A nice bail to handstand there. Goes for her dismount here. And a nice double front. She seemed to kind of lose her feet there at the end, but she finished strong after that fall.
Back over on beam for Kentucky, we have Sydney Dukes. She's following Katie Stewart's 9.85. Pretty combination there.
Thank you. really showed off those 180 degrees on those leap series.
Looking to finish up strong with the dismount. Gets that stick, nice routine.
Up on bars will be Anna Marina, a junior from Naperville, Illinois. She's a bar specialist. Solid release there. Really went for that handstand.
On beam, we have Alex Highland. Very solid flight series there. Routine for the Kentucky Wildcats. Before her, Sydney Dukes had a 9-point.
Being a Nebraska gymnast has definitely been something that's way bigger than myself. Growing up, I was usually kind of just the only one there and didn't really have a lot of teammates, and just being able to have all 16 girls around me and coaches who continuously push me to be the best I can, it's shaped me to who I am and has been such a great experience to be a part of.
Sienna's one of my best friends here at Nebraska, and I'm gonna cry at the end of tonight probably, or when she leaves. I'm really gonna miss her. Throughout every single practice, I know I can look to her, and she believes in me, and she's believed in me since the first day I got here more than I've believed in myself, and I think that's really helped my gymnastics, and I would not be where I am today without her.
Sienna will stop at nothing to get what she wants. She has the kind of determination that you strive for and that you always look up to. She is such a great role model inside the gym and outside of the gym. She puts others before herself and always wants the best for you.
I think that she's grown in her leadership. I think she's grown into her as an individual, and the confidence that she brings with that has been able to produce some really great gymnastics out on the floor, and in my opinion, some really great friendships on the team as well.
To the girls on the team, you guys have been one of the most special teams that I've gotten to be a part of here. I want to say thank you for giving me advice even when I didn't want it. I want to say thank you for calling me out when I wasn't trying my hardest, because you guys know what potential I am capable of reaching, and without you guys I wouldn't have had such a fun and amazing season. Thank you for each being you and letting me be a part of such a great finish to my career. Something that I plan to take away from my journey here is just knowing that no matter how big the goal is, as long as you work hard and surround yourself with a good support system, you will get there.
Over on bars, the lineup will be Caitlin Oral, then Sarah Hargrove, Addie De Jesus, Megan Versellis Carr, Sienna Krause, and Taylor Houchin. over on the bars, where we have Caitlin Orrell starting us off for the Huskers. Starts off with Dukachev. Very solid overshoot to handstand. Gets that stick. Good routine for the senior, Caitlin Orrell. Awesome. Good finish on beam there for Illinois State.
Over to floor with Kentucky. This is Haley Poland. Last week on floor, she scored a 9.8, and the Wildcats had a
49.525 on floor last week, which tied the best event score in school history. So they're coming in hot on floor.
Up on bars is Sarah Hargrove, freshman. Starts her routine off with a nice ray.
Nice stalder. Hex alto to the pirouette, nice.
Truly extending those lines and hitting all those handstands so far. A nice stick for Sarah, that should be a great score.
That was a great routine by the freshman.
Caitlin Orrell, the last bar routine, had a 9.8. And we are back to floor with Kentucky.
And this is Katie Stewart.
A big double pike to start, a nice landing there. The first routine for Poland on floor was a 9.75.
And last week, Katie Stewart had a 9.85. Over on beam, the first score for Illinois State was a 9.6.
Nice second tumbling pass there. We will be back over to bars with Addie De Jesus. Sarah got a 9.9 on that last routine, so that was a great start for the Huskers. And here Addie goes.
That should definitely be a career high for Sarah. Got that last handstand.
Nice blind full right to a double back for Addie, and a stick landing.
Crowd is excited.
See that replay there on that double back. A nice stick. Awesome job.
She's excited about that.
Next
back over to Beam with Illinois State. The last beam routine was a 9.55. Back over to Bars. Here's Megan Verselli's car, the sophomore. Last week on Bars, she scored a 9.825. Good Jaeger to overshoot connection. Before her, Addie had a 9.9.
A great blind full landed right on top of the bar to another great dismount. The Huskers are off to a really strong start on Bars tonight.
Great routine, great start, great first few routines for the Huskers.
Back over to floor with Kentucky.
Ella Warren.
Nice front double full on the floor. It's a very difficult pass.
Showing off that choreography. Nice leaps.
Back over to Bars, we have Sienna Krause, the senior.
Nice Weiler.
Ginger right to a bail.
Huge. Nice last handstand.
An awesome routine for Sienna Krause, the senior, her last time competing at Bob Devaney.
As Ella Warren finishes up her floor routine for the Wildcats.
And Megan Versailles' car on Bars at a 9.875. Huskers are doing great on Bars so far.
That should be a huge score for Sienna.
You can hear the crowd cheering. We're seeing if Sienna Krause may have gotten a 10.0. One judge gave her the 10.0. Not sure what the other score was. We will get that to you as soon as possible. But we are now back with Taylor Houchin, the junior, on Bars.
Krause ended with a 9.975, a career high. Beautiful lines from Taylor.
Nice handstand there. She goes for the dismount here. A beautiful double layout with a stuck landing, and the crowd goes wild.
Wow. Over on floor, we have Alex Hyland for Kentucky.
That's some fun choreography there. Previous floor score for Warren was a 9.85.
Taylor Houchin also got a 10 from one judge, but will end with a 9.95. Gearing up for that last tumbling pass. Chung on bars exhibitioning.
She goes for a blind half right to the Jaeger. And a pack salto. A nice handstand there. It's ready for the dismount. Awesome job for Kelly. What a great, great bar rotation for the Huskers. They should be extremely happy about that.
They'll end with a 49.6. That is huge. That's definitely a season high for the Huskers over there on bars. Wow.
Over on beam. Back answering, back layout, step out, very nice.
Very nice jump combination. And that last jump, she loses sight of the beam, which makes it extra difficult.
Lost her balance on that turn there, but she did a really pretty turn with her foot in the back, which is more unusual than you normally see.
Add some extra difficulty.
A nice cat leap to a front toss there. And a nice dismount with a stick. A great routine for her.
Over on floor for Kentucky, Molly Korth is mid-routine. Very nice. Rudy to back layout step out pass.
Last week she had a 9.95, which was a career high for her. She has a pretty solid routine going so far. Just one pass left.
Gonna finish strong. Before her, Alex Highland had a strong 9.875. Very strong finish, great routine.
Illinois State should be finishing up on beam here. I believe this is Kylie Meyer. The back handspring, back layout, step out. Didn't quite make that. Hopefully she can finish strong here.
Very nice leap connection. Really hit the 180. Solid connection there. Dances out of her full turn.
Ends with a gainer pike. A great strong finish for her.
Over on floor, this is Sydney Dukes finishing up for Kentucky.
Last competition, she had a 9.9 on floor.
Before her, Molly Korth had a 9.875. Gearing up for that last pass.
Finishes with a nice round up backhand spring double tuck.
She's excited about that routine.
As soon as all the scores come in, we will update you with the scores after the second rotation.
This is just such a cool honor to be part of such an amazing tradition and to follow in all the footsteps all the people have gone before us and to help this next generation come up and start something new and something even bigger than what we've been able to do here.
I love Kate. She's awesome. She's always dancing. She's always having a good time. She's a great person to hang around. She's funny. She always boosts the mood around people. If she's smiling, everyone else is smiling.
You have grown so much as a leader. You have one of the kindest souls I know, and you are honestly like my partner in crime.
Really any event, just her, she's so charismatic and the way she moves and directs eye contact, you can't help but just to watch what she's doing. One thing that me and her really just connected with right away was that she wanted more. She wanted to push herself to the limit to be the best she could be, and she believed in all of the capability of this team and what this team could accomplish.
We can never get you to stop talking, which is what I love about you, because you will say whatever you have to say. And I just am so thankful for the relationship we have built over the last 4 years.
I think she has the ability to ignite the fire on the team. And I also think that something that's special about Kate is her performance value. She has the ability to just live life to the fullest out on the floor, and I think it's a lot of fun to watch. It pulls people in. People want to be her. People want to watch her. People want to join with her in creating that environment, and I think that's something she brings to the competition floor that's pretty special.
I would say being a student athlete is kind of like the vehicle. It's the vehicle to get you to where you want to be the rest of your life, and it kind of helps you learn all those lessons that you need to learn to be successful in other areas of your life, and I'm just so grateful I've had the opportunity to do that.
For the Huskers, the beam lineup will be Sarah Hargrove, Caitlin Orrell, Megan Schweighofer, Sienna Kraus, Taylor Houchin, and then Sierra Hassel. We have Illinois State on floor. Nice double back to start. We got Sarah going on beam. Sarah's a freshman from Henderson, North Carolina. Beautiful backhand swing, back layout, step out. Looking to start the Huskers off strong on beam. Pretty front aerial. Really nice split jump to a sheep jump. She looks very composed tonight. Doesn't look too nervous, looks confident. That's great. Solid routine so far. Here she goes for her dismount. And a gainer pike. What a great finish. It's an awesome start for the Husker beam. That was a great start for the Huskers on beam, as you saw that replay there. Getting ready to watch Danaea Davis on vault for Kentucky. She is a senior vault specialist. Last week she scored a 9.825, and let's see how she does. Very strong, Yurchenko full, really knew where that landing was. Just a little hop in place. Sarah Hargrove started off beam for the Huskers with a 9.8. And here we have Caitlin Orrell on beam. Last week she scored a 9.775. And here she goes tonight. She is a senior out of Missouri. Very solid flight series for Caitlin. She's one of the four seniors celebrating senior night tonight. Nice split jump to a double stag. Looking smooth and confident up there. Wants to finish strong on this dismount. A nice round off 1.5 with a stuck landing. A great routine for Oral. Husker should be happy with that. The first floor score was a 9.675 for Illinois State. And the second routine just finished on floor. Over on vault, Kwan started off with a 9.8, Dukes with a 9.725, and Davis with a 9.825. And here is Katie Stewart on vault for Kentucky. Last week she had a 9.875. A wonderful Yurchenko 1.5 for Kentucky.
Sticks that landing. That'll be a big score for Kentucky. That's awesome. We've got senior Megan Schweihofer going on beam now. After Caitlin Orrell put up a 9.8. Good series by Megan.
She goes for a leap series. A switch leap, switch half to a beat jump. It's a nice series there. She executed it well.
Pretty full turn by Megan. Pretty solid routine going so far for her.
Here she gets ready for her dismount. She does a round off double full with a stuck landing. That was beautiful for Megan on her last time competing in Devaney.
Yes, another one of the four seniors celebrating senior night tonight.
Here's a replay on that dismount. A nice round off, double full, and there's that stick.
Over on vault, Katie Stewart just put up a 9.975. Kylie Meyer on floor for Illinois State put up a 9.725 in the number two spot. And Molly Korth on vault finished out Kentucky with a 9.95.
It's a great vault rotation for Kentucky. And this is Mia Quigg on floor for Illinois State.
We're heading back over to beam for another Husker senior, Sienna Krause.
Sienna is from Fargo, North Dakota. And last week on the beam, she scored a 9.8.
Good front aerial to back handspring connection for her series. Full turn. Just keeps moving up there. Switch leap to straddle quarter for her leap connection.
A solid front toss there. Here she prepares for the dismount. A gainer piked full and a stick. Wonderful for Sienna.
Nice routine. She should be happy with that.
Kentucky's vault score was a 49.4, another huge score.
And before Sienna Krause on beam, Megan Schweihofer put up a solid 9.85 score.
And on floor, LaRoche had a 9.8.
On floor, this is Gabrielle Cook for Illinois State. little talk there as we go back over to Beam for junior Taylor Houchin.
Last week, she scored a 9.9 on Beam. Here she goes for her series, a back handspring back layout step out. Very nicely done. Should be no deduction in that.
Very pretty front aerial.
A pretty full turn.
Beautiful leap series there. Switch leap to split jump.
There was a cat leap to a side aerial. She's doing very well on the beam. She has no wobble so far. And here she goes for her dismount. Round off double full with a stick. That should be an amazing score. She should be so excited about that.
That was a great routine for the Huskers, and that's following Krause's 9.925. That should be a huge score. I don't know what they'll deduct.
Taylor Houchin had a 9.95 on that last beam routine, and here is Sierra Hassel from Johnston, Iowa. Last week, Hassel had a 9.875. Huskers off to a great start. Let's see how she does.
Great series. Looked super confident there. Did not budge at all.
A very nice front aerial. Very solid.
Beautiful split jump to sheep jump combination there. She looks very solid and confident up there.
She's a very consistent beam competitor. She puts up a lot of great scores for the Huskers on this event.
Wants to finish strong with this dismount here.
A round off 1.5 and another stick.
Wow.
The Huskers are doing amazing tonight on beam.
They are on fire. They got some momentum going and just kept it rolling. Wow. As you watch that replay, you can see the excitement of her and her teammates.
And the final floor score for Illinois State was a 9.825 in their total score. We will get back to you with that. Illinois State had a 48.85 on floor.
Come on, Judge. And if you can hear the crowd erupting, Sierra Hassel got a 10 from one judge, giving her a final score of 9.975.
That's huge. That's amazing.
Over back to beam, we have Michaela Curtis doing an exhibition routine. So just a reminder, the score will not count towards the final, but Nebraska ended with a 49.5 beam score, which is huge.
A nice wolf jump to front tuck. Very solid again. Nice acro series, backhand spring back layout step out. She looks very confident up there tonight as well. They have a lot of depth in their beam lineup, so they've kind of been rotating in and out their athletes week to week, just seeing who will compete best at each time.
Switch leap for her leap combination. That's a very difficult combination that she just did.
A nice dismount for Michaela. A great, great exhibition.
Very solid routine. We're going to be having one more exhibition on beam from senior Kelly Chong.
Here goes senior Kelly Chung with her exhibition. Michaela's exhibition score, I believe, was a 9.8. She starts off with a nice backhand spring back layout step out for her acro series. A little shaky on that leap series, but she contained herself. Beautiful full turn. And the dismount with a stick. A great routine for Kelly.
That was her first beam routine in competition ever as a Husker, exhibition or not. So that's awesome. We are through three rotations here at Devaney tonight at the Masters Classic.
The teams will be heading to their final rotation. The Huskers on floor, Kentucky on bars, and Illinois State on the vault. After the first three events, the Nebraska Huskers are leading with a 148.3, Kentucky with a 147.975, and Illinois State with a 143.225.
Gymnast has been everything that I've ever dreamed. Ever since I started in the third grade, I've always wanted to become a college gymnast and be like the older girls. And Nebraska has given me that opportunity to make my dreams come true to get a great degree, to meet a lot of new friends and have teammates that I'll talk to for the rest of my life, to have a great coaching staff that's pushed me and wanted what's best for me and developed me as a person, and also just having such great fans. You guys have been really great to me. Thank you. One legacy I want to leave here is that everything's bigger than yourself. So being able to give back to the community and enjoy the whole process of doing that, being able to give back to your teammates and coaches for all that they've done for you. So just, I just want the girls to remember, like, it's bigger than yourself, and being able to accept that and enjoy that is just gonna be the best thing that you guys can do.
I think my favorite thing about Shwai and I's relationship is kind of how we interact when it comes to Beam. I think that, like, she speaks out to me about needing me to kind of be there for her and remind her confidence throughout her Beam routine. And she always comes to me before I compete on every event and just tells me that I have it and I can do it and to have confidence in myself.
She's always been like a huge role model for me, and I always wanted to be like her even when I was still in JO before I got to Nebraska, and I've always looked up to her. Like, she's an amazing gymnast and she's an amazing person as well.
She doesn't really pretend to be anybody else but herself, admits when she's wrong, but has this unique ability to just be Shwai, you know? I mean, just go out there and live life like Shwai.
Okay, so ladies, next year, I just want you all to work so hard and just continue building everything that we have brought up this year, and just to continue that process of getting that national championship. I would love to see you ladies get that, and I will be your number one cheerleader along the way.
The floor lineup for the Huskers will be Sarah Hargrove, Abby Johnston, Caitlin Oral, Addie De Jesus, Sierra Hassel, and Sienna Krause. And here is Sarah Hargrove, the freshman, about to begin on four. And a really big double pike to start off. Front layout, front full for that second pass, stays in bounds. Here Sarah goes for her final pass. A round off back handspring double tuck with a lot of height and a clean landing. A great routine for Sarah. Fun ending there for Sarah. Great first routine for the Huskers.
The first bar score for Kentucky, Stewart had a 9.775. And on vault, the first score was a 9.5. She did a Yurchenko layout full, a little bit short on that landing, but overall good vault. And here we have Abby Johnston, the freshman. up on the floor. Last week on floor, she had a 9.725. Starts with a nice big double pike. Clean landing, got a lot of height on that.
She's got a fun routine, can really show off her personality.
A nice round off whip half to a front full. Really clean landing there.
You can tell that she has fun with this routine. Teammates on the sidelines dancing along too. Great leap series there.
Here she goes for her final pass. She's looking really strong so far. Round off backhand spring, double tuck. A great routine for Abby Johnston to put up a good score.
Great routine by the freshman. Sarah Hargrove started off with a 9.75 on floor for the Huskers. Back over on bars with Kentucky.
She goes for the dismount. And a double layout. A nice duck landing. Beautiful routine there.
Over on bars, Nixon with a 9.85 and Kwan with a 9.825.
Here we are back over on the vault. Anna Yurchenko full. That was a nice vault for them. And back to the floor, we have senior Caitlin Orrell.
She's a great performer, so just sit back and enjoy this routine.
Run off back handspring, double pike. A nice first pass. What a great performance she has with that dance.
Strong round of backhand swing double tuck for that second pass.
Nice leap series there.
She's having a blast out there.
And here she goes for her final pass. And a great routine for Caitlin Orrell. She should be so excited about that. What a great performance.
Such a fun routine. Abby Johnston before her, 9.8. Bars for Kentucky put up a 9.85.
And we are back on bars with Kentucky. a nice piked Jaeger. She has really nice lines. She's really hitting those handstands.
Great overshoot to handstand there.
A very difficult but well-executed dismount. That was a double layout with a full twist. You don't see that often at all. And we are back on floor with the freshman, Addie De Jesus. She also opens up with a very difficult pass. Triple full. And there it is. What a nice landing there.
She's another one who looks like she's just having a blast out there. Great performer. Solid second pass there, a back one and a half to a front layout step out. So just walks right out of that pass into her dance.
Makes it look really easy.
It's a fun routine.
And a round off backhand spring double pike to finish it off. That was a big routine. To update on scores, Illinois State had a vault score of a 48.4. And Kentucky with a 49.225 on the bars.
So both Illinois State and Kentucky are finished with the meet as they wait for your Huskers to finish up on floor.
Caitlin Oral scored a 9.875, excuse me, on that last floor routine. And here is junior Sierra Hassel. Last week on floor, she scored a 9.9. And that last floor score for Addie De Jesus was a 9.825.
Very nice for a handspring front double twist to open up for Sierra.
Nice round off one and a half front layout.
Good routine going so far. Very solid on those first two passes. Very nice leaps right into her dance. Teammates and audience clapping along with her routine.
She finishes with a beautiful front handspring Rudy to a straddle jump. What a great night for Sierra. Should be a really big score.
Yeah, that was a great routine.
And here is senior Sienna Kraus to finish off the Huskers.
Sierra Hassel before her put up a 9.925.
Beautiful first pass. A front handspring, front double fold to a front layout. Super difficult, but she executed it extremely well.
She's just a natural tumbler.
She makes it look very easy. Another great tumbling pass. The Huskers are looking so strong tonight. I'm so impressed.
They got some momentum going and just took it and went running.
Sienna is competing all around tonight. This will be her last time competing in Bob Devaney. She's had a very successful career, and here she goes for her last tumbling pass.
Looking to finish her night strong. She's had a great night so far.
A front handspring Rudy to a back layout step out. That was beautiful.
What a great routine for the senior. What a great way to finish off her night and her career in Devaney.
That was an extremely well performance from the Huskers. We will update you with those final scores as soon as possible.
For Sienna Kraus for that routine.
In the meantime, as we wait for scores, we'll have an exhibition from Michaela Curtis on floor. She is a sophomore from Savannah, Georgia. Round off back handspring double pike.
Getting ready for that second pass. Very nice front fold, the front layout.
Double tuck. A great finish for Michaela on that floor routine exhibition.
Yeah, strong exhibition from Michaela there. And a great night for the Huskers. What a meet.
And that concludes the final.
girls are heading out onto the floor to get ready for awards.
We are still awaiting the final scores. And with the final scores, we have Nebraska with the win with a 197.675, Kentucky coming in second with a 197.2, and Illinois State in third with a 191.625. Nebraska will then begin the postseason with the Big Ten Championships on Saturday, March 23rd in State College, Pennsylvania, before awaiting selections for regional and postseason competition. What a great competition tonight, and we'll see you next time.
Thanks for watching.
I think the seniors, every single one of them, is a great leader in a different way, and I think that really helps the team, because whether you need to be led or motivated in a different way, you have someone to look to. And one of the things I'm going to take from them the most is from freshman year here, so 3 years ago, I guess, they have evolved so much in their leadership abilities, and I think that just shows me how much I can evolve in my leadership abilities, and I think they've really impacted this team for the better.
I see Nebraska Gymnastics in turning into even more of a powerhouse than it already is, based off of focus on details, work ethic, leadership, team connectiveness, and the senior class embraces all of that. And you have your workhorses, you have your leaders, you have your people who are focused on the team chemistry. Each senior had a different role, but together they embodied everything that Nebraska Gymnastics is going to become.
The senior class is so passionate about what they do and so determined, and that is just something that I look up to as an individual, as a gymnast as well. And they have just put in so much time and effort, and they always go in there and they work hard with smiles on their faces, and it is something that I greatly appreciate and look up to every day.
Every single person I've gotten so close with, and they've helped me grow in my gymnastics, and also our friendship and as a person. It goes beyond that. Every single day, I just look up to them in anything they do, and every way they've helped me grow.
All of the seniors were a very big help and were all very welcoming. They all play a different part on the team, and I can look up to all of them in all different ways.
This senior class is going to be remembered for their bubbly personalities that through all the setbacks this season and in the past seasons.
You know, every time they faced a situation, they learned from that situation. And this class as an entire whole has faced every challenge, from injury to losses to you know, the struggle of school, the you know, long distance relationships, just about anything and everything that could possibly happen has happened to this particular group. I think it's brought them closer. I think that this group each brings a unique strength and a unique talent to the group, and I think that they value that in each other.
I think all four of them have played such tremendous roles for this team, and even though they've all been a little bit different, they've all played those roles to the best of their abilities, and whether that's competing all around every time or just simply being there for the team and cracking jokes or just being a great friend to go to, they're really gonna leave a great mark on this team, and we're for sure gonna miss them next year.